Packers, hands down. This gentleman has developed technology and products, the Carrier Motion, which is available in the Class 2, Class 3, the Carrier Clear, now the Carrier Motion Colors, of course, the Carrier SLX Bracket System. And all these products are certainly providing significant increased efficiencies and profitability and overall shortening treatment times in the practice. So it is always an honor and pleasure of me. Please join me in welcoming to the stage Dr. Luis Carrier.
Thank you, Taylor. Thank you very much. Thank you. Good morning, doctors. Thank you for stopping by here. Today, we're going to see how we approach the different malocclusions. This morning, at this first session, we are going to talk about class 2, but we are going also to talk about class 3 in 1 hour or something like that. So how we approach the systems with this system, the malocclusions, how we bring the case into a simple platform to achieve a shorter treatment time and a more simpler treatment time. Well, we reclassify the case. We simply convert a class 2 case into a class 1 at the beginning of the treatment. In fact, Dr. Engel already established the classification of orthodontics as a class 1, class 2, and class 3 malocclusion. So he was highlighting the elements that were more important in a malocclusion, that is the sagittal dimension. The sagittal dimension is something that is the most difficult thing to solve in a treatment in orthodontics. So we pretend to change at the beginning of the treatment those elements that convert the class 2, that classify the class 2 as a class 2, the sagittal condition, and bring the case into a class 1 platform, into a class 1 case. And from the class 1 case, then we are going to approach the peripheral elements of the malocclusion. If we look, sorry, let me see. Now, if we look at the already Leonardo da Vinci saw that the simplicity is the maximum form of sophistication. So we try to do simple the process using simple appliances, using simple designs for our treatments. I think we're running out of battery here. So orthodontics is a matter of facial aesthetics. Orthodontics is a specialty in which we manage the position of the bones, in which we manage the position of the teeth, in which we achieve a nice positioning of the teeth, and we nice relation in between the bones, in order to what? In order to sculpture the face. So orthodontist is a facial aesthetic professional. Orthodontist is not just a tooth mover. Orthodontist is a manager of hard tissues to sculpture soft tissues. And for sculpturing these soft tissues in a nice manner, we can, because we have to remember that the lips, they are not self-supported. They are supported by the position of the bones, by the position of the hard tissues. So the lower third of the face is the one of the most important areas where the beauty is, where the attractiveness is on a certain patient, because we can sculpture the supramentalis sulcus, we can sculpture the nasolabial angle, we can sculpture the nice relation in between the nose, upper lip, lower lip, and chin. And we are pretending to do so by balancing the relations. We have many tools to measure. Many tools, for instance, Leonardo da Vinci also gave us this beautiful distribution of the proportionality of the face. The face has to be proportional in 3/3, an upper third of the face, a mid third, and a lower third. But the lower third as well, this area that where we really impact, can also be split in 3/3, that all of them have to be proportional and balanced in order to give a nice face and a nice harmonious element for the face of the patient. Today, the patient of today is a patient that is not a patient that doesn't care about the face. It's a patient that examines every corner of their face, examines it from one point, from the other angle, and not only that, is posting his face or her face in many platforms like Facebook, like Snapchat, like many others. So are experts of facial aesthetics. So we cannot play games with that because they use their face to be attractive to the others. They use their face to be having many likes and this and that. So in the past, the patient was not really concerned about the face as they are today because we were looking at the mirror in the morning, in the afternoon, and at night. But the patient of today is looking themselves many hours and many from many perspectives. So today we plan to compare cases, cases that fall on the same type of malocclusion, on the same type of angle classification, class 2 malocclusion, but with different elements, elements that are completely different. One will be class 1, class 2 division 1, another will be class 2 division 2 with deep bite. But we are going to approach the cases exactly in the same way. Here we are. We have a case in which we have a retrusion of the mandible in the upper and is a class 2 division 1. And here we have a case that is a class 2 division 2 with a retrusion of the retroinclination of the upper incisors, a flaring out of the lateral ones, and the mandible also retruded. In both cases, the situation of the incisors is completely different. One of them is protruded. The other one are retroinclined and blocking the mandible back. But we don't care. We don't care because the incisors are not really changing anything at this level. We don't care because we're going to manage the sagittal condition at the beginning, but this sagittal condition is going to be the one that is in the posterior segments on canines, premolars, and molars. In mixed dentition, we normally position this appliance on the first upper molar and on the temporary canine. But cases like this, that maybe he has a molar that is excessively medially rotated, then we are obligated to position it on the temporary molar for some reason in particular cases. But the objective is the same. Convert the case from a class 2 into a class 1. And in this process of converting the case from a class 2 into class 1, what is going to happen is that we are going to invite the mandible to be repositioned, relocated forward, because normally these malocclusions, they establish a wrong condition of the relations in between the condyle, the base of the cranius, and the position of the disc, that we can take advantage of that and bring the case into a better sagittal condition. So further growth that can fall on this case then will come on the new scenario of this new position. So in a case like this, what we look for is to convert a class 2 into an overcorrected class 1, which means a little bit of class 3. Why we overcorrect a little bit into class 3, the class 2 cases? Because the occlusion, the bones, the teeth, are not anatomically as the permanent ones, and there is a certain instability of the occlusion on mixed dentitions. So we pretend to overcorrect in order to establish a platform that will be hold until the change of the permanent teeth. So we can see how we can enhance a mandible that is retrusive into a beautiful balance of a patient that we overcorrected in order to establish a platform for accomplishing a good relation. But in the class 2 division 2, also, that has a retroinclination of the incisors, that the mandible is blocked, we are not going to release those incisors. In fact, we are not going to pay any attention to those incisors because we are going to start moving the posterior segments, and this movement of the posterior segments will invite the mandible to be relocated forward, and this mandible that will be relocated forward will push the upper incisors from the lingual side, uprighting them and diminishing the deep bite spontaneously. As it happens here, and now that here, we don't have anymore the deep bite that the patient had. Now, at this point, we can change, and once we have accomplished this overcorrected class 1 platform, now, with a small howley with an anterior bite plane, we can really reposition those incisors beautifully without any kind of problem. For instance, the difference in between a retrusive case and both retrusive cases with a massive protrusion of the maxilla. In both, we need to advance this mandible. In both, we need to bring this mandible forward in relation with the maxilla. In both, we need to balance the position of that. And in both, we have totally different scenarios. One of them is a class 2 division 1. One of them is a retroinclination of the incisors. One of them is a class 2 division 1. One of them is a class 2 division 2. But the approach is going to be standardized. It's going to be the same. It's going to be an approach in which we are going to approach those cases on the same way. How we do it? Well, we will place the motion appliance on the upper first molar and on the canine. And of course, in the lower arch, we always protect that with a vacuum aligner. A vacuum aligner that has to be rigid, and normally the size, the thickness is 0.4 inches of thickness. And this will act also as this occluder and a slide path to help us into the correction and to invite the mandible to be relocated forward in a better sagittal position. So we start and we accomplish a class one platform, a good occlusion in class one. We start here, we place the motion, and we accomplish a class one platform. Now, from this standpoint, we have completely changed what we had at the beginning. At the beginning, we had a class two. Today, now, 3 months later, we have a class one occlusion, and now the case is much easier. At this point, once we accomplish a class one platform, then we place the brackets. Normally, we use the SLX bracket, which is a high-performance passive self-rigating bracket. Now, we close the spaces, and we start the retraction, and once we start the retraction, we bring everything in place, and we keep going. But the most important thing, that we balance the profile. We bring the mandible in a better sagittal condition. We accomplish a total new relation in between the maxilla and the mandible. By what? By inviting the mandible to be relocated, by changing the occlusal plane, by bringing forward the mandible, pushing down the gonion, inviting the pogonion to go forward, and relocating the structures at the temporomandibular joint level. Not only this, we also work on the airway and on the position of the structures. Or this class two division two. Well, it's the same approach. We place the motion, we accomplish it, and here we have what we accomplish at the end of treatment and the evolution after 6 years of active treatment. So we can see the evolution of this. And the important thing is that the relation of the structures at the end of treatment. Or these two cases in which both cases are retrusive, but both cases mainly also have a very difficult nasolabial angle, in which the nose, if we change anything at the nasolabial angle, what will happen is that the patient is going to have an open angle of the nose, and the nose will be the protagonist of the face. So we have to manage those tissues without any diminishment of the volume. Of the maxilla. If we extract two bicuspids in a case like this, the impact on the maxilla of the patient will be deep. The nose will be highlighted, the lip will disappear, and now the patient will have a terrible profile. So it's an option that we cannot go in any of both cases. But if we manage those teeth that the patient has without any kind of extraction, and we just redistribute what the patient has, what will happen is that at this point, what we are going to accomplish is a nice positioning of the teeth, but we will not diminish the volume that supports the soft tissues, so will be a total neutral impact on the nasolabial angle. So both cases are retrusive, both cases they have a nose and a relation of the upper lip and lower lip. But both of them, they have a class two, a full step class two. And immediately what we do is we bring everything in a good relation. So we start here and we accomplish a class one platform. But in this one, we accomplish a class one platform in 3 months. Why can we accomplish this fast? And why this overjet that we have here, disappears after 10 weeks here and after 3 months here? Why is disappearing that? Well, because there is something that is very important, that is the joint. The joint, on those cases of class two, they have normally the condyles back and up. And these condyles that are back and up are migrating the disc forward and is stretching the distal ligament of the disc and is contracting the mesial part of the ligament of the disc, which is the upper head of the lateral pterygoideus muscle. So this relocation, this wrong location of the disc is pushing the condyle back and up. By changing the occlusal plane, by inviting the mandible to be relocated, our intention is to bring the mandible back and forward. And it's what we do. Now we relocate the disc in the correct position. Now we have a different scenario. Now the relation is much better at this level. The relation is much better at this level. So once we accomplish the class one platform, we switch to the SLX bracket, we follow the archware sequence, and we end up the case. The same happens in the girl. Once we accomplish the class one platform, we place the SLX bracket, we bring everything in place. When we do the retraction of the anteriors, when we bring those interiors back, what we have to make sure is that we never attach the power chain on the molar. We only place the power chain on the 5, 4, and hook. Because if we attach a power chain on the molar, we derotate forward the molar, and then we lose what we don't want to lose, is that the nice rotation to the distal that we accomplish with the motion. Now, after accomplishing the adequate positioning, we can see that a narrow airway has completely been opened. We can see that a narrow and obstructed airway now is wide. Now we have a canal that is a wide canal. This is what we call airway-friendly orthodontics, okay? And the most important thing, we did not pay any token at the facial level. The face that at the nasolabial angle didn't change. Didn't change because we did not eliminate it material from the maxilla. We did not change amount of material from the maxilla. So we just redistributed the same amount of material. After, this is 13 months of treatment. After 4 years and a half, the case will remain stable. After 6 years, the case will remain stable. And after 10 years, the case is going to remain stable. And here is the evolution, in a 10-year evolution, of a retrusive case that was relocated in a better sagittal condition, and now we have been evolutioning in a good-looking boy. Here we can see the patient in action, when we can see that many girls must be crying in the deepest of the night with this. Eh? Or here we have this patient that we accomplish a nice relation of the profile. And not only this, we open the airway beautifully because of this relocation of the mandible. And here we have the treatment at the end and the treatment 2 years after. And which has been the evolution of the face? The face, the evolution of this face has been into a nice positioning. This is what we try to do in the bones. Bring the mandible back and push everything in a better sagittal condition. Bring down, release space at the top, and bring the disc into the correct location. Again, we go back again, bring the mandible down, gonion down, pogonion forward, relocation of the disc, and balancing the structures. This approach is amazing on cases in which the patient is having temporomandibular symptomatology. So we have seen a nice release in several patients with the use of this appliance on these scenarios. So here is the evolution of a retrusive case with a very sensitive nasolabial angle that we accomplished a nice relation that now, after 2 years, is looking nice, and now we can see how self-confident she looks and how she can do the selfies with the friends, looking at her face from different perspective and balancing the face. That is the most important element that we do in orthodontics, balancing face. We are professionals of face, and we have to claim this area in the society that the orthodontist is a professional of facial aesthetics. Or when we have patients that they have a flat profile and the scenario that is a flat profile, but both of them, they have class two, when they are not retrusive, normally the joint is in the correct positioning. So on those cases, the action on the mandible will be completely neutral. We are not going to change anything. We are not going to be able to change absolutely anything because the joint structures are nicely positioned at the beginning of the treatment. Although the patient can have a class two, anyway, the scenario, the joint is looking beautiful because it's in good position. So in those cases, the effect is going to be only on repositioning of the teeth, dental veolar repositioning of the teeth, without any postural change of the mandible, without any postural change of this mandible. So it's not possible to bring this mandible forward because at this point, the joint is in the correct position. So what we do, we place the motion, we accomplish a class one platform in this lady of 51 years old, we accomplish in 5 months. In this other lady, in another girl, we accomplish in 3 months. But the most important thing is that this now, at this point, we go from this point to the other, and now we have a scenario that is so easy to solve. Now there is no complexities. No elements that are really tough to solve is much simpler. So at this point, we place the brackets, we bring everything in position, and we accomplish the case beautifully, and the same happens in the other case. By the way, we had a little bit of extrusion of the canine in this particular case because she was starting from an extruded standpoint of the canine, but this is something that is not concerning us because it's not really important. But if we don't want, what we can do is to position the motion instead of placing on the canine, we can place a shorty. We can place a motion that goes to the first from the first molar to the first premolar. And with the first premolar, what we have is a palatal cusp, and this palatal cusp is keeping a good occlusion and keeps everything in place because the canine is not having any palatal cusp. Okay, but the important thing in 1 year and I don't know how many months, but we accomplish a class one platform. But 10 years later, those cases are beautifully stable. One of the strongest points of the use of the motion is the stability of the results, the stability of what we accomplish, the stability of what we look to accomplish, and the most important thing, maintaining the beauty, maintaining the freshness, maintaining and the what we look for, to give freshness and fighting the aging and welcoming the youth of the patient. So this patient we ended up at 50 years old, now in 62 years old, looks beautiful and will look beautiful at 72 as well in 10 years, and at 82 probably also will be beautiful. So this is the objective of orthodontics, balanced tissues. The objective of the orthodontics is fighting aging, welcoming youth. How? By moving, by positioning, by balancing the own tissues of the patient. We are the unique professionals out there that can really manage the tissues of the patient and balance. Or cases like this, in this case that had a full step class two, that had a flat profile, without altering the amount of teeth in the maxilla, what we do is we generate a totally respectful facial approach. Look at the nose. Look at the relation with the nose, upper lip, lower lip, and chin. Look at this curvature. Look at the nice relation. Nice change because we have been very respectful with this particular case, okay? Look, those two cases, what they have in common? Absolutely nothing because both of them, they are retrusive. Both of them, they are class two, but one of them is a class two division one. One of them is a class two division two. Okay, one of them is class 2 division 1, and one of them is a class 2 division 2 with retroinclination of incisors. The mandible is completely blocked by the upper incisors, but we don't care about that because the motion is going to help us to upright spontaneously the incisors because we'll relocate the mandible forward in those two cases. Why? Because the joint of these two cases is in the wrong position, because the condyle of these two cases is up and back, and this is pushing the disc forward in a wrong position. So what we pretend is to bring this in a better position, bring that and do this movement in a better situation, okay? Imagine, look at this scenario, patient of 27 years old, in which is not going to grow and is not willing to have surgery. Can we help her? Absolutely yes, because these patients that are so much retrusive all of them, they have a wrong position of the joint. And it's interesting to balance the joint. So we invite this joint to be balanced properly. And the other one, we can also help him. Although this patient is complete retroinclination, deep bite, 57 years old, and at the same time is subdivision. So here is a class one and here is a class two. But we, in subdivisions, we are going to place the motion in both sides. Because what we have seen is that in those subdivisions, if we place the motion only in one side, what happens is that in the other side, sometimes tends to lose the class one that we had. So we like to overcorrect a little bit on the side of class one in the subdivisions. So normally, we are going to place two motions in mixed dentition. Now, we place the motion. In this particular case, we place the clear. The clear, and we accomplish a class one platform. This is a case that now, look at the object. Look at the object here, 27 years old. The question, is the mandible grown? Has this mandible grown? No, absolutely not. Why? Well, because what we have done is just relocating the structures at the temporomandibular level. Okay, at this point, now the scenario is completely different. Now the patient is occluding with a certain, with a good position. This retroinclination, we place the motion, and once we accomplish a class one platform, look, the upper incisors have been uprighted and protruded. Why? Because the mandible has been pushing from the back, uprighting them, and diminishing the deep bite. So amazingly, we approach those cases on the same way. We can treat with aligners this case beautifully. This would be a case that will be easy to accomplish with aligners. But we don't care because the patient doesn't care, so we go for brackets, and we end up the case, with a good profile, with a good relation, with a nice scenario in which we avoided the necessity of surgery, and we avoided, and we did one thing that is more important, a short treatment time. Today, if you can shorten the treatment time, this is the most important thing that your patients will value. Forget about long treatments. They are not going to be happy with long treatments. So we try to shorten their treatment time. But the most important thing, that the patient, at the end, shows us that she can do something that was impossible to do. Protruding the mandible in a case that was so much retruding. Why? Because we release the disc from the area where it was wrong. Why, at this moment, the disc is not more in a wrong position. Now the patient can really position the mandible in a beautiful area. So we can see here how she looks. How she looks, a retrusive and a correct positioning. And what we do here? So first thing, we protect the lower arch, we place the motion, and we retract the posterior segments, looking for the class one occlusal lock platform. This is diminishing the overjet, because we are positioning the joint in the correct positioning. And this is bringing the pogonion forward. So everything is connected. This is why we changed the name into Career Motion 3D, because it's a three-dimensional approach to the malocclusion and to the overall case in all areas, at the airway, at this and that. The demand is the same. We accomplish class one platform and we finish. But the most important thing, look at the change of the profile. Look at the nose here. Look at the supra, the nasal label angle. This is much nicer now. These small changes is because we don't change, we don't alter, we don't remove this. These two cases are very nice, but both of them, they come to us for Invisalign. Well, if a patient like this comes for Invisalign, if we do extractions, then what will happen is that we'll ruin the face of these patients. So we don't want to ruin that. Okay, so what we do is we going to convert this case into a class one case. Class one, or class one, here, this is the girl, pam, pam, pam. So now, both cases are easy cases to solve with Invisalign. Now, we can treat those cases with a short period of aligners. This is what we look for. Treating those cases with short period of aligners. But the most interesting thing, The most interesting thing, now we can remove and send the scanners, send the PVH impressions or whatever. But the most important thing, look at the change of this beautiful girl 3 months after. Now it's much nicer because the mandible has been relocated also in a better sagittal condition. This is what is interesting. We are not working only in teeth. We are working on face, on relations between the mandible and the maxilla, on relations between everything. And now we can place the aligners and end up in a short treatment of 13, 12, 14, 15, 16, 18 aligners, but not in 40 or 50 aligners, which is not worth. Invisible does not mean long, means invisible and short, has to mean invisible and short. And hybridization of structures, a sagittal conditioner, as it is the motion appliance, will convert all our cases in short periods of Invisalign, in short treatments of Invisalign. And for ending, for instance,